I am at the Tham Luang cave, which got world famous in 2018 when a group of young boys got stuck here because the cave was flooded. And then the boys were stuck inside the cave for several weeks. And yeah, throughout this video I'm going to tell you the story of these boys. Probably most of you know the story because it was in the media all over the world basically. It's actually a pretty a good story with a happy ending. And then yeah, this is the cave where everything happened. I'm not going to go inside, it's actually also not allowed. The cave is closed. So I basically think this is the furthest we can go. You can see it's a pitch black over there as well. Wow, but I remember seeing the whole story about the boys in German television as well. Wow. Seeing this pitch black cave now here, I wonder why somebody ever came to the idea to go into this cave. Wow, it's yeah, if you know the story of what happened here, it's really like a weird feeling to be here now, because also one person died in this story. And yeah, the story basically is 12 boys, local boys from a local soccer team called the Wild Boars, and their coach, who was 25 years old, came to the cave after their training. And actually they left their bikes right here. I saw pictures of their bikes and their bags standing right here at the entrance of the cave. So yeah, after training they came to the cave and they went into this cave. Seeing this dark hole here now, I wonder how you can actually enter the cave. And you can hear the river flowing there. Looks like a really strong current down there as well. Pretty scary, I have to say. So I'm not sure if I would dare to go in there. But yeah, these boys and their coach, they went into the cave. And while they were in the cave, there were heavy rainfall and the cave got flooded. So the boys and their coach, they couldn't get out again because the water level was rising so high that the way out was blocked. The families reported them missing. They found the bikes and their bags right here at the beginning of the cave. Then, yeah, a whole rescue operation started. And it took actually 10 days to find the boys deep inside the cave. They were found 4 kilometers inside, which is like 2.5 miles. Inside the cave, they found the boys after 10 days. And yeah, Thai Navy SEALs were involved, professional cave divers, lots of policemen, soldiers. Here, the whole area was, yeah, full with people involved in the operation. And what I really, really like about this story, which makes the story actually a very good one, is that people from all over the world came to help to rescue the boys. Like divers from all over the world, from China, from the UK, from America. So many people came here to help the operation. And in total, like 10,000 people were involved. That's what I read on Google. Like over 100 divers, cave experts, policemen, soldiers, and also many local aunties who were here giving food to the soldiers, to the divers. So lots of people were involved in the mission, the operation to find the boys. And yeah, they found the boys after 10 days. Everyone was alive and actually pretty all right concerning the situation. But yeah, that was not the end of the operation, finding the boys. The hardest point was actually to get the boys out. Because yeah, even for professional divers, for professional cave divers, it was really, really challenging to dive through the cave, because there were really narrow parts with almost zero visibility underwater. It was still raining the whole time actually, so there was constantly new water flooding into the cave, and they were pumping out water constantly. So incredible. And yeah, imagine like getting 12 young boys out of such a situation, and most of them were even not able to swim. They never dived before, and then they had to do one of the most challenging dives basically in the world. And that must have been very horrible. Like imagine how these boys must have felt being stuck in the cave for 10 days before somebody found them actually. And then yeah, they got food supplied, and as soon as the boys were found, and there was always somebody with them, there was a doctor diving inside checking the health of the boys. So after the 10th day they were not alone anymore. But yeah, then it also took several days to get the boys out of the cave. And yeah, unfortunately one Thai Navy SEAL, a former Thai Navy SEAL, died in this operation as well. From what I read, he ran out of oxygen while diving a challenging part, and yeah, he lost his life while trying to rescue the boys. And what a hero, right? What a hero. He was even just a volunteer here. He was a former Thai Navy SEAL, so he was not active anymore, so he was volunteering here. And yeah, what a hero, giving his life while trying to rescue the boys here. And the second diver died several months later because of a blood infection that he actually caught here inside the cave. So yeah, another hero actually, also dying in the end because he was involved in trying to rescue the boys. That is the sad part of the story. But yeah, the good part, the happy ending, is actually that yeah, in the end all the boys and their coach were rescued from the cave and then brought to hospital, where they had to quarantine for I think 14 days because yeah, of the danger of getting some unknown infections inside the cave. In the end they were reunited with their families, and yeah, the last boy was rescued from the cave 18 days after the boys and their coach entered the cave. So yeah, imagine being in a cave stuck for 18 days as a like 11-12 year old boy. That must have been a horrible experience. I wonder how these boys are doing today. Probably they're all living still around here. And now it's, yeah, like I said before, actually a good story, which really shows that yeah, the world can unite. So many people from all over the world were involved, helping Thailand, helping the local authorities, the local divers to get the boys out of the cave. So actually, yeah, happy ending in the end. All kind of skilled experts, 10,000 people from 23 countries all over the world. That is insane, right? Came in with the one purpose, to rescue the kids. And the total mission was 17 days, 4 hours and 29 minutes. So yeah, almost 18 days. And yeah, if you want to get more information about the whole story here, there are tons of documentaries and videos about it on YouTube. There are even two major films, I think, about the whole event here. United as one. I think that is a great motto. United as one. Standing together, helping to get the boys. What a story. Thanks for watching, guys. Stay healthy, stay positive. See you on the next episode. Ciao.